Hi Geminis, welcome back to my channel, Aquarius Empress Tarot. For those of you who are new to the channel, my name is Jackie. Thank you so much for visiting my channel. Geminis, I did not forget you guys. I was having so many problems yesterday with YouTube uploading videos. I had done a video for the Divine Feminine. I had done a collective video, and all of those videos, like, there was an error uploading the video. So anywho. Geminis. Let's see. I don't have my handy Rider-Waite tarot deck on me, you guys. But look, okay, the situation is I'm at work right now in the break room area. And I love you guys so much, Geminis, that I said, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and use my oracle cards, okay? So work with me today. But this is your what do they want to say to you, Reed, Gemini? Because I know y'all be having a whole lot of stuff going on, Geminis. There be a whole lot of people involved in your life, from family to crazy exes, baby mamas, all kinds of stuff going on. So this is for all my Jimmy Jims out there that watch my channel. Just do keep in mind, Geminis, that this may not resonate with every Gemini. Check your sun, moon, rising, and Venus signs, please, because that does play a factor, and we are dealing with energies, and energy is fluid just like time is fluid, okay? Here we go. So what do they want to say to Gemini? Let's see. All right, so I'm going to cut the deck, Gemini. Excuse the noise. Excuse me. UPS is always outside of my building, so I hear the trucks. Okay, like, ooh, Gemini, you got the attraction card. I don't know if you can see that, but the art in this card is absolutely gorgeous. It says seduction, temptation, magnetism, a passionate encounter, meeting halfway, coupling, sexual union. I feel it. Somebody's got the feeling for you, Gemini. I feel it. There's a lot of yellows in here in this car. A lot of yellow and orange and reds. Ooh. The reds to me are, it's a lot of passion here. There's a lot of chemistry between you and this person. So if they could tell you something that they, they're really attracted to you, Gemini. Okay. Just hands down. They think you're the shit. Two, that they really want to have an intimate connection with you, for sure. Okay, let's see, what else does Spirit have to say? What does this person have to say to you? Dispersion, it's a pretty card. Okay, but this card says diffuse negativity, restore harmony, circulate, revitalize, dissolve divisions, and lighten up. So they definitely really want to restore this connection. I'm kind of getting like a vibe of wanting to reconcile with you, Gemini. They want you back, baby, come back type of situation, Gemini. Like, they don't want no smoke with you, Gemini. Also, abundance. Ooh, this is a beautiful card. Like, all those flowers, all that. Again, a lot of yellows and reds. So, but they see, I feel like this is how they see you, Gemini, as abundant, right? Plenty, generosity, fertility, ripeness, inner riches, reaping rewards, culmination, harvest. So they see that you work really hard, Gemini, and that you are reaping the benefits of all the hard work that you put in. That's what I'm seeing here. What else? What else do they want to say to you? They see that you are abundant and you are doing well for yourself. What do they want to say to you? Ooh, the Marrying Maiden. That one came out. That's beautiful too. It says, a compromising situation, subordination, succumbing to seduction, manipulation, low self-esteem. Honestly, Gemini, I feel like this person may have low self-esteem. They may. They may. Yeah, they, you know, they struggle, I feel like, with their own image. And, yeah. I feel that here. They may feel chained to someone. And this is the Marian Maiden card. I don't know why I feel like with this card, this person may be... They may be chained to a relationship that they're not happy with. It may be a committed relationship. Maybe there are children involved because... with the abundance card, we did have fertility. There could be children involved. There could be with this person, but they feel like they have such low self-esteem. Yeah, low self-esteem that they're in a compromised situation that they can't really get out of right now, which is why they're probably not taking action towards you right now, Gemini. But they do see you as abundance because we do have the abundance card here. Check it out. Yeah. Gorgeous. What else do they want to say to you? Opposition. I love this card. This is beautiful. It's gorgeous. So you see, like, their faces are like up and down, right? You guys may have, I feel like with this card, Gemini, you guys may have different expectations for a relationship because both of you have different pasts. So whatever your past is, this other person that you've been dealing with, maybe they view like commitment as y'all live together, or you know, you text every day or call every day, but you're wanting more of a traditional type of relationship. I feel with the flowers and stuff here, to me that signifies some type of marital union to me, with the pinks and the white. That's what I get, just, you know, like a bouquet of flowers for a wedding. But yeah, I feel like, yeah, personal differences, a communication gap, like maybe this person is definitely... Honestly, Gemini, hands down, y'all are good-ass communicators. So I definitely don't see this being your energy. This is their energy. There is a problem with them speaking up to you, like telling you how they feel or telling you what they think, because there's a communication gap, disharmony, misunderstandings, estrangement. This person may be estranged from you at this time. Like, you guys aren't even speaking. But if they were to speak to you, they would let you know how sexually attractive you are, first of all. That they don't want no beef with you. They're ready to diffuse the negativity. They see you as doing well for yourself, and they really do want to be a part of your life. However, okay, the Marian Maiden comes up. They may still be in a codependent relationship with someone. Because I see how the chains is around this wedding dress, this woman wearing this dress here. I feel like they may be in a codependent situation, Gemini. Please do me a favor and comment down in the comment section below and let me know what's up. Because I really want to know. I'm nosy sometimes. Contemplation. This person, right off the bat, Gemini, this person has been thinking about you. They're in their head about you. Yeah. To me, this is like hermit energy. This could be like Virgo energy. Contemplation, gaining overview, detached observation, increased understanding, solitude, integration through reflection. Or this could be you. Maybe you just kind of like, okay, whatever. They're not talking, okay. I'm unbothered type of situation, because you know that you guys have personal differences, opposite viewpoints. You guys don't see eye to eye on things because this person is still stuck with somebody else. There's that third party. Damn, third parties always come up whenever I do Gemini readings. It seems to always be a third party. I'm gonna get two more cards. The Gentle, penetrating, a soft approach, faith, moderation, a subtle but deep influence, understanding, and nonviolence. I feel like this is you, though, Gemini. I feel like this is your energy. Like, you know, you're not gonna, like, pop off. I mean, unless they start something. But, you know, you kind of backed off. You kind of fell back. Kind of doing your thing right now. In contemplation mode about the things that you need to do right now, you know, to take care of yourself. Let's see what else. Yeah. Completion. I feel like this is a cycle that you guys have completed. Like, whoever this person was, they probably were a karmic in your life, to be honest with you. Just to be real with you, Gemini, this person probably was a karmic. They came in, they left out just to teach you some type of valuable lesson about self-love, and you know that you have everything you need to succeed without having another person as validation. Celebration, final attainment, victory, a crescendo. Job well done, perfection, peak performance, and prudence. So there you go. And we'll get one more card. So yeah. If this person was speaking to you, Gemini, this is what they would say to you. I'm gonna put it into their words. They're very, I do see you as a very attractive person, right? We have a lot of good chemistry together. We vibe really well together when we're together or whatever. But I don't want any problems. Like, I just want to squash the problems between us with the communication gaps, the different viewpoints, because I don't want the problems. I do see you as, you know, I see you out there doing your thing, and you're doing well, you're very successful, and I would like to share in a part of that. That's what this person would tell you, Gemini. But, here comes the but, right? But I do have other things that I'm dealing with. I'm in a compromising situation right now, where there's a lot of disharmony, right? Personal differences, estrangement. So I'm still with an estranged wife or husband. Take it how it resonates, Gemini. This is what this person would tell you if they were really being real with you. I've been thinking about this a lot, and I would like to come in the brown. There's a lot of brown in here, in this card. I don't know if you can see that up close, but there's a lot of brown. To me, it makes me think of earth energy. I would like to come in and give an offer something, but only after I've completed this cycle. That's what I feel like they would say to you. Yeah, only after I've had a victory in completing this cycle, but I do want a victory with you, Gemini. And that has been your What Do They Want to Say to You reading, Gemini. Please hit the like button as well as that notification bell. And comment down in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.